Okay, so as a company, we'll do about $60 million of revenue with about more than $25 million of profit, making it plus 100 crore profit company. We have like 1,100 people sitting out of Delhi, Bombay, Chennai, Bangalore, primarily, and then many more places. I started that way back in 2000, to be precise, December 2000, and then went through very interesting parts, which is what I love to share and talk about to you guys. The story didn't start in 2000, actually. It started in college days, where 1994, I entered Delhi College of Engineering from a city which, in a school in a city where I didn't know how to study in a more language that we speak here in the metro cities called English. So I studied more Hindi medium school, not in metro city or city, even a town which was very far away from Aligarh and Salagar. So lucky for me that when I entered DCE, because it was an objective type question answer, I could see the answer, I could see the question, and I could understand what they are asking. I mean it. I didn't know how to read the text of the question that is written explicitly. I knew that what the dimension they're saying here, meter per second, and second is the answer. It means there's somebody somewhere, meter. So I kind of, in my early days, believed that every question comes with an answer, and literally answers were given in front of you, and you were to literally choose what is the right answer. That was like objective type questionnaire. So I could get into DC sort of examinations, but not into the great IIT, because they used to ask to write examinations, which I couldn't write in English, because in Hindi they didn't use to select that. That's a very interesting entry I had in my college. When I entered, I had a Tare Zameen Par moment, because I come from a background where you do not know how to, first of all, speak English as a medium to learn your physics, chemistry, and then you come in the company of people who are so super smart to the extent that in my college, I had people which were DPS toppers, or my UP board rank 4, or a person who was like CBSE rank da-da-da-da-da-da. Everybody was somebody superstar, actually, that's what it is. And from being a front bencher in my school, which is what made me get entry nearly, I started feeling bad about the moment that I got into the college, because I could not understand anything and started becoming the backbencher. And soon I started becoming no more in the class, and from the hostel I was not getting entry in the class. I was like starting to get dropped from the first year very much. That part was, I was, when I entered college, I was 15-year-old. Okay, now you would say, how can you enter engineering college as a 15-year-old? Because lucky for me, I was one of those guys who did not study one class in middle. I skipped and so on. My school teachers did that to me. So I was even very young for this college, actually. I used to get ragged, and I was like a kid, and people will literally play like a football to me. You know, they can just bully me like anything. So, I mean, it was so traumatizing life that I was thinking, hey God, take me out of this place. Can I run out of this college and go back home? Except that I come from a background where I was the only engineer in my family. You know, some of you might get associated with that sort of feeling. All your mother first dreams were that they will have one engineer out of their college, out of their family, that engineer will go someday America and they will have a blank check to get married to, or find somebody to get married to a blank check. Come from Aligarh, UP, you know what I mean by all that. Oh, except that there was only one thing that was holding me and stopping me, which was just really this, my mother's tears that if I get out of college, I don't know how will I face that all. Life was enough dramatic to the extent that I did not know how to read the magazines. When I was not getting in classroom, some of my nerd college seniors will take me to the computer center. Come with me, I'll take you. So I was sitting in front of a Unix dumb terminal in my age, which was, I was supposed to learn filter design, if you know. I was an electronics engineer, by the way, by the entry. I started doing shell script programming early on. Because, again, you know, for me, I didn't know. I didn't know computers first. I mean, I didn't know what is a CPU. I used to think the dumb terminal has a CPU which is so thin, literally. And then, I used to think, why didn't my school, which has a BBC Micro, install Windows? I now know so many answers. So, quickly, I go to libraries, I try reading books, because I figured out that it is better place, because I'm struggling with my own life, myself, versus a life which is in the classroom, which is struggling in the middle of super smart people, and being shamelessly, I was young, you know, those ears get red, nose get red moments. So I never got into classroom. So I would getting in the library, trying to learn what is called computers for all heaven's sake. Life was really horrible. Next step. I used to see these advertisements which used to show fancy notebooks. I, who used to use Bhargav Hindi English dictionary, would open the notebook and will not figure out how come a computer can be called a notebook. I mean, and I would not know anyone here and there whom I can ask. Again, you know, age, pre-bullied, hostel, fresher, attempt to talk, rag, you know, 10,000 reasons. It took me 2 years to ask my another colleague, as an hostel colleague, who joined hostel and I got comfortable, come, let's go to the library, I have a few questions to ask. Ki le notepad kahan hai isme? Where is the notepad in this? And he then taught me that how computers are becoming notepad-like, that's why this is called notebook, and so on. Well, interesting thing, in 1995, I entered college in 94, 95 happened. My college was going to get an internet connection. The computer lab was my let out. It was not my destination, but let out. I started becoming help to my senior who was managing computer center, started going into the computer center. I started setting the ERNET, the ERNET thing that you remember if you. And then I got an email address very early on before anybody else in the college would get. I started finding something that I have something versus I'm not up to or I'm superior to these fellas. Good. Now that I had email, I started setting up BBSs out of my college. I started making the websites, Tripod, GeoCities, should you guys remember some of those things, free web space, hunting, and then creating these websites. The website, we had only text access in the Lynx browser. I ended up hacking the VSNL servers and they blacklisted me in life. That you will not go. Yeah, I mean, like, it was a very simple hack that you could, and then XSSIDO was like really dumb. You know, they used to not even use it, I can tell you. Pune was the worst of the GSDLAs and GSDLO1s and so on. So, incidentally, life goes on. I became more of an internet guy, less of an electronic engineer. In third year, I found a company called XS Corps. XS Corps, because X and S. S for Supreet, whom I had a crush on, cross for so that I don't remember her. And, okay, in Delhi they call a term called FOSLA, Force One Sided Lovers Association. Laat padne ke baad. XS Corps, devoted to someone whom I never could say hello, the early nerd. I started doing internet programming. Call whom? No one. My college, senior, junior, college website, hostel website. Hostel website, college website, what do you mean by that? Alumni connections, feeling happy. I used to think about like what my mother will think when I will not pass, because my supply count started increasing every semester actually. So I'll have 2 supplies pass attempt and 2 supplies welcomed attempt. Really horrible days. I didn't know that whether I'll even get a job out of college actually. I just had a clue that I wish that I get out of this college movement. But I knew that I knew something on internet which was superior than other people. Okay, so I thought, why don't we do a business around it? Because a lot of people ask for these websites to be created, this web service to be done. Except that I was in college, so I can't do a sitting in college business. I all the way don't have even network in Delhi City. I found out a very cute way to find out business. In the newspaper, I slipped through the classified pages. I found out job advertisements for HTML and whatever animated GIF and Photoshop they used to have. I'll go and give the job interview to this person, and once he will ask me what is the salary you're expecting, I'll say, actually I cannot take a job, can you give me the work that you have? So, I had a ticket, and you know what, I wrote that data page first query of Delhi Bombay on a CGI page which was giving output of schedules of flights that were there and so on. That's like I made my first 1,000 on one of those queries. This guy asked for CGI developers in the market. I quickly started making enough money on my internet business that I did not even have an aspiration to get a job out of college now. I was getting out of third year of college. Quickly went on, I talked to my mother, can I go and do my own business? She obviously vehemently middle class of this country does not support startups or the culture that we all in this room called rebellions do attempt. So I was told, no options. only a job. Job, I went on to do a little bit of hunting, what is the best paying job in the campus. It was in those days, Riverrun Software Group. I found out they need all Tenenbaum and Swamp Series Ghatta, which means you have to make all the Ratta. I just figured out that in July month, I will do 1 week, 2 weeks of studying of this, and I cracked that test and I was in front of interview machine. This guy is asking me questions on pointers. You know, the guy who does Shell Script Unix programming pointers. First question answered. Second question attempted. Third question, really you think this will be the answer? Oh, you are right. Fourth question, and like, are you really going to, seriously, I put a question. Do you really have only C questions? You said, yeah, you passed the C test, right? Yeah, I mean, you passed the test. You know, fact is, I did not pass the test. I studied 2 weeks back, and I just did as much as I could do in the examination. So don't consider me as a C programmer. Consider me as someone else. Someone else? What? Actually, I believe in internet. This is a speech that I'm going to give this guy in 1997. I believe in internet. My gods are Mark Andreessen, Jerry Young. I think that fiber optic pipe that you see in the NetGuide article on Netscape, where Mark Andreessen is pointing, this is how money flows in our office. That is the dream I live. I live a dream of internet for all. I live a dream of being an internet businessman. And so why doing this job? Because my parents wanted to. The guy understands that out of college, all the background, they check me, why would they want him if you're doing something. I was very open and honest about it. I sit in my college system administration. I have supplies. I just want to tell you, you do not ask. You do not check our mark sheets. Those who will pass, you will hope that they will pass in the classroom. I just want to tell you that I don't have a pass. I have 4 supplies, 2 in this semester, 2 in next semester. And on, we talked about Unix. Obviously, I had a t-shirt in the college which used to say root at DCENT, root at DC here, and it used to say Unix inside here. I mean it. I lived that life of that nerdish Unix life. Here, finally, those guys actually selected me. They asked me the final question, do you have any questions? I said, will you select me? And they said, yeah, we'll select you. They pushed me into their company's business development department so that I can help. So engineering college graduate getting selected into business development department. They put me into the internet side of things. You know what I mean? Order processing on internet. Now they had a cold fusion markup language. Who knows that bullshit stuff, you know? And that sort of crap. In 6 months, I was like itching around. And I didn't tell you a very interesting thing that we were doing when I was saying that we were making these websites. On a parallel note of life, me and a friend of mine who taught me what is Notepad called Notebook, we started figuring out this country will need a search engine. We started building a site called IndiaSite.net. It was like an a la Yahoo directory. Plus, we started finding out that there will be excite kind of botting of Indian site that we have to do. Can I tell you what are we doing? We were building search engine when Larry and Sergey were building their search engine in the valley. We never found our Rajiv Motwani ever. Yeah, you can't believe it. I have tears in my eyes to tell you that how much we were passionate about that India will need a search engine or there will be a search requirement for the web that we are seeing is growing and we couldn't find somebody to back us up. That said, we were doing the classic debate over what you make a product or a service and we knew that we have to survive or float or make quick money, as we might like to call it. Moved out of this company in 6 months because the thing that I was doing was really something that I believed in. And I used to have these business world top front page showing Alok Mittal, India.com, the VCs funding these internet companies. The bubble was coming in. We were in a company doing a job when I, as an individual, had a dream of doing something like that. I couldn't hold it for more than 6 months. I kept the promise of mother that I'll keep sending $10,000. So I used to sell hosting on the side, $5,000. Whose hosting sold ₹10,000 home. I'm doing something of my own. I actually did an awesome amount of job. We started making revenue. The company comes from New Jersey. They do acqui-hire. Some of you know this stuff? Zuckerberg does this. Acquires companies who hire you. Scilab guy, who was Google AdSense CTO, Indian book, was hired by acquiring his company. Useless company otherwise. I mean, it's a stated word, not that I'm saying it. This company comes all the way from the university. They knew our gang. Gang meaning my same old college buddies. So we were making, you know, I was full-time into it. I grabbed my second friend full-time into it. Two of our friends who were working in Uke Software Systems and CDOT, they used to come in the evening and night. So we used to have the 24/7 working. Me and my friend will work in the day. They'll come in the night and work. And we were making a search engine. We were making these Indian election sites called India Decides that we did as a partnership with the Living Media and so on and so forth. We were actually making revenues on it. And finally, this guy comes and buys us. And now, what do you mean by buys us? Actually, this guy decides to tell us that we can give you a crore should you guys want to decide to come. For a set of people who were living in thousands and lakh rupees of billing which don't get collected, a crore was a sweet check. Founders, co-founders divide in these movements. These are the moment of truth. Who was the ugly Jobs and who was the pure was an act? This is the moment of decision. I was for money and my two of them were for the, we'll continue the company. Actually, you know what? I had a problem. I did not know how internet will make money. I just didn't have a clue how will internet make money. The thing that we are doing, it is very simple for large IT services companies to do. Someday they'll start doing it and this is what we don't want to do. We actually started building CMSs, content management systems, pre-XML era. We put up a language called triple hash, news, double hash, hash 3. You know, typical like a template language for our CMS, which was like really hot. We sold our, we had customers like Living Media, I told you, Express Computers, Express India, Agency Facts still exists on that CMS and so on. Incidentally, the problem was that I didn't believe in that internet will make money because there is no money at least. And we didn't know anything about VCs or venture capitalists who would give money. And anyway, they don't make money. I mean, like you take money and then you have a liability to give back money, which is what is I decided that we'll sell. We sold. We split like four of us split like four different directions immediately. This company gave us a lock-in of a year, typically, right? You are acquired. Your incentives are being paid. And you're going to live a life of at least 1 year lock-in at a very massive thing. Okay, so I used to have 15-day royalty, which is like the part of component has to pay us cash, and another 30th day cycle, which was like another 15-day later salary. So every alternate week, I used to make a couple of lakh rupees, by the way. I was living in an unreal world. I was 21. I was earning more than anybody else that my batchmates would have thought about and anybody else would have think about. I used to go to a place called Punjabi by Nature in Delhi where there is something called Golgappa Shot, which is Golgappa with a vodka. And I will order Golgappa Shot without vodka because I don't drink. That we had those cool green cycles to roam around in Noida. We had these smart 98100 series phone numbers kept at the back, biking. Okay, 2-3 questions. You can't have 4 friends living in one house. What is the question? No fancy thing. But we were like totally, horribly dissatisfied with the life because Rajesh Jain has sold his company for $125 million. And then there were so many companies which were getting these hundreds plus million dollars. Who loves these 100,000 rupees every 2 weeks when you can do hundreds of millions of dollars? It was such a pathetic life we were living. I decided to call it quits in this company. I decided the place that we used to incidentally, okay, so in my college days I used to fancy Stanford. Wanted to love to go to Stanford. Again, I told you, right? Valley stories, all this, thank you, the journey of the internet. But now that we were working at this place and this company which I was, they bought my company, they bought 2-3 more companies. So we used to have this founder section and this alley was called Silicon Alley because we were not in Silicon Valley. So out of Silicon Valley, this side and that side, our company people were sitting this side, that company people were sitting this side. Two of them, two of me, this, that, we decided to quit. I decided to quit on the day which was 11.5 months of my employment in this company. we were acquired, we were locked in with golden handcuffs for 12 months. We were given supreme upsides if we stay for 12 and 24 months. When I resigned, this admin lady and the finance lady says that, are you serious, you're resigning? Yeah, I just said I'm resigning. You know, you stay for 2 more weeks, you get 16 lakh rupees of cash for retainers bonus. We are actually preparing another ESOP policy. Your last year shares get vested completely. You know how much it is going to be? I said, the amount that I'm leaving here will be my vow that I will remember, that I'll create something which will be much more worth than what I'm leaving at this cost. It included 60 lakh of cash on that day. I started doing things. I rented to do things actually. I started doing chemistry online. If it's clicks, it's chemistry, it's for broadband ISP. Last mile was BSNL world. I quickly figured out it is not going to fly. By the way, it was AOL, BOL, COL, chemistry online. BOL BSNL le liya tha, COL mera jayega, AOL yes. Yahoo bought 411. 411 was people search. And AOL bought MapQuest. MapQuest was a $1 billion buy. 411.com was like a $400 million buy. My friends on this side of the alley decided to do Manchitra. I decided to do 197 because that was people search for the country. That's why 411 equivalent 197. I go to the operator, say, give me the telecom directory data. I will make it free and available on internet. I know what this country's consumers are waiting for. They just start checking me out saying, as a mobile operator, we are not allowed, or even if this is part of our license, they're not going to give you the data. There is no policy which we are accepting that we have to publish directory. I hacked into BSNL and MTNL's directories, Foxbase databases, very random low-end encryptions. I put them up on internet, and I think about and I dream about location-based services, because Fed government has said E911, which meant all 911 calls were to be tracked. So I'm living a pseudo-American life of what is happening there will happen here. You know, literally that sort of day. I'm doing 197.com, which is people search. I'm trying to do location-based, and actually what I do is people search on internet, which is on a website. A friend of mine, IB Saxena, BabaBajar.com. Some of you might remember these two words. Pulse me. You have this people search data on the internet. Airtel is asking me to make a people search. So can I take this data for SMS query? I said, yeah, you can. And I would just think, and he said, okay, I'll give you the revenue that I make from Airtel and revenue share it. I said, okay, yeah, sure, why not then? Just do it. Actually, these SMS call was a phenomena. 16 rupees call, 8 rupees call meant that people were going to dial these call and give a missed call. You don't know who called. Then you want to send an SMS of this number and find out whose number it is. Sarma ji ka number hai, Jor Bhagma dete hai. Very nice. That sort of thing. And the answer was, soon my internet dream will start going down. This is, I'm talking about 2000. Actually, 2001 was starting. This is why I started with 97 end of 2000 December. Soon 9/11 will happen. Soon, all internet wet dreams will go down the drain. Soon, only one revenue that I'll make of 250 rupees will come from this SMS service. God closes doors. They say he opens one. I did not know this 250 rupees will be my door. But I truly believed I probably found out how to monetize content, finally. Coming from the internet days where I was chasing where the content monetization will happen, I believed in it. Because I made 250 rupees, by the way. Now, I want to meet this operator. I just want to check the 197 thing. I want to go to this guy. They find out a scapegoat in me. They decided to give me one interesting thing. They wanted to change a vendor of live astrology service. Pandit ji call pe baithe honge dusri taraf. Short port pe call aayegi. Aapke Pandit ji answer karenge. I was like, okay, sounds good. We can do it. So, do you have an astrology experience? I'm quoting that I used to run a site on this astrology and so on. He's not even bothered. I said, how much will I get paid for? He himself decides. I'll make 4 rupees or 5 rupees. I'll give you 50-50. So, 2 rupees a minute is your revenue share. And you hire Panditji, computer, yours, phone, yours. We'll give you SIM cards on which the call will come. You know, you know what I'm talking. I'm sure most of you know. By dialing a number, you can talk to Panditji. They're going to charge a normal call rate. Normal call rate. I decided that it is better to take this business because the only way to meet customer is once you have some interest of customer. I had no interest to do it, but I had all the interest to do it because I wanted to see this guy again, because I figured out there was a content revenue. Soon, I was in a business which was Panditji sitting in my office. My sister calls me. I thought you were an engineer.
Yeah,
I am. And then what is this Panditji? And we had a pact. Once I'm out, I've given enough money, we'll not talk about these things. No. Janapatri kaise chhapoge? Jarurat padi to woh bhi karenge. Thank you, bye. I remember this dialogue actually. My family started to disown me quickly. It was like exponential, log x curve. Ex to upar jayega na, log x curve. I was like, okay, you guys don't understand. I've discovered one of the world's European problem. How do you monetize content, dude? Now I want to go to Airtel. Coming from internet, I know the cricket is a frenzy, music is a frenzy. I tell them, I know what is called user experience. These stupid IVR services that you're running, don't even bother about what consumers want. They crappingly keep navigating him. I think I can do better job. They look at me. And by the way, we know at your place there are only Panditji, you don't have engineers sitting at your place who can do this thing. So please don't pitch this anymore to us. I continue to tell this guy, you do not know, it is not about engineering, it is not about engineers at my place, it is about user experience. If users will love, they will come back again and like the service and we will have a better service. I swear on God to tell you, they actually literally started avoiding me. I was 21. And these telecom operator guys, like 34, 35. One of them literally used to told me, why do you ask me? Bacche ho. Okay. Now what happens is, I am going to get a lucky break on this curve. Airtel bought this JT Mobile, which is Punjab, Turk and Hyderabad. Right? These are circles for JT Mobile. And the problem was, JT Mobile did not roll out Punjab Circle, and Airtel was asked to pay penalty and roll out Punjab Circle. So their budgets were tanked by 250 crore, which were DOT penalty. They said, oh, by the way, you were telling me the music and cricket things. Go to Punjab, Chandigarh jao, wahan pe milke aao. I get to Chandigarh. I'm preparing this PPT, which is like, I know what consumers want. I have seen and made these great consumer applications on internet, and actually, you know what? That ticker that you used to download cricket app, ticker on the desktop, were one of those things that we introduced in this country. So one of those services were also ours. So I'm making this pitch to this guy. Very, very, very immersed into that I know what consumer want moment. And then this guy says, so how much will it cost? These were actually IVRs, okay, for our level of discussion. I don't have to fancy it. I knew it is 12 lakh rupees if you buy a single even is like a 30 call condensed into one wire, like an even. Even is equivalent to 24 calls. I said 16 lakh rupees per even server. I don't have budget. And then why we here? I thought you really believed in these services. I did. So why do you want to sell these services? What else you want me to do? Why don't we do the same deal that you do in Delhi, 50-50? I said, you said you believed in this. Yeah, I'm thinking about it. 50-50? I did not wait because I was knowing that I was serving every call port equivalent Panditji was being break even in Delhi. I said, okay, deal done, 50-50. Guys, we discovered the revenue share business model for mobile entertainment, mobile content industry. Their platform application content will be done using only revenue share as a business going forward. Everybody in the industry will have to follow this business model. Because previous to that, they used to do bill of material for different guys. I started deploying. I went Delhi. I had all my cash flows out, by the way. All my rich money was out because operators don't pay in time, they're big monoliths, they're small young guys, This is called impedance mismatch of 440 volt versus 5 volt gap. And soon we were in the business, because I went early, I took a server for 50,000 rupees, I pushed that in this place, changed the UI to one third of the guy who was doing it in Delhi, actually the same guy I picked it, and so on. I started doing music, I went on to do cricket, Airtel liked me in doing these services, they pushed me into JT Mobile, I quickly did this, and I asked, is there a music license to IPRS, Indian Performing Rights Society? And they said, yeah, there is, for internet. I said, do you have a mobile license for music? They said, no, we don't have for mobile. Okay, so you know, do what? Give me an internet license versus I took mobile on top of it. So they said, no, we don't know what is, how can mobile play music, man? You write internet and mobile. Negotiate. Okay, 9 lakh rupees. Sir, we are a startup, early stage, we need your help. 50,000 rupees for 10-year license to play unlimited music on mobile. I mean it. In 2001, I had cracked it. I got that license in my hand. And then, I started doing more places, music service, music on demand music, send an SMS, listen to a song, everything. You know, all sorts of things. I was dreaming 197 McKenzie study on mobile entertainment. This guy says, I said, you don't realize, this is such a big game changer for content industry and entertainment industry. It will be so big that you won't know. And I mean it, because I know that how less we make revenue when we go on internet. There is no way I can consume this content. You know, I started making this content, and I was making like money again. My bad days are on the curve next. The guy whom I was taking these machines from the rent, actually I was not able to pay him the rent in time, because I was not able to collect the bills in time. I didn't have the tax pay kind of system which would remind me where the customer and where is everything else. I used to maintain it on Excel sheet. There was no cloud-based accounting software, and I used to not have India's most popular commercial software. Obviously, I could have not used it, I realized today. So, I used to manage on Excel sheet, which means I didn't have a clue who has been billed, who's not been billed, who's been collected, who's not been collected. Everything in a single monolith Excel sheet. That's like a bad design in software. You should have service-based architecture. Bills here, collections here, you know, everything else that we talk. Oh, this guy says, pay my all outstanding of historical servers, which was kind of 8 lakh rupees, and I'm going to pull these servers out now because I have a customer and you've not been paying me enough. The customer was Pepsi World Cup. Pepsi was customer who in the Cricket World Cup took that number, long number that you, when you take the Pepsi strip off, they'd say, this company got the contract to do that. And he said, okay, enough of your business, give me 8 lakh rupees, I'm putting this. I literally was overnight, my machines were taken off, I was on the floor, my Panditjis were watching me, and I had 8 lakh rupees outstanding to pay. I went to my sister's place once more, got that money, 8 lakh rupees, on a 24% rate of interest, because I was having no collateral, even though I was relative. But that said, 24%, I will give you 24% rate of interest, and I took 8 lakh outstanding completed. So you know what, I know a business model, I know a thing about this business, except that I'm living with only my Panditjis, and I don't have money to buy one server because I'm actually negative. This is the time when a company out of Bangalore, Infosys baby, called On Mobile comes in. The big blue, I'm reading the biography actually. So it comes in and takes over the stage. The creativity vanishes. The juices go out, the corporate walks in, and then we will have this big, awesome company doing everything that I was doing on the terms that I was doing, because they were not able to sell even before me, because they were asking for fixed fee of their platform. They didn't have a clue how can they do services, or how can they, you know, the Bangalore companies have a problem. They don't make products. They actually are, okay, so all these adjectives said. Great software service companies, nothing more than that. They care a shit about user experience. Number of people in this room who bother about user experiences, I have only one thing to tell you guys. Your product is your user experience for your customer. And I mean it more often than less number of time I say it. But there was no more creativity in this ecosystem. We were thrown out. I went back to the company of internet days. I started giving consultancy. I had this signeddomains.com registrar. This guy calls me, "Can you run my domain registrar?" Bhavin Purakhiya, direct I, should you guys know him? I asked him, okay, logic boxes ka pehla customer mein tha, by the way, should you guys know? And so on and so forth. Parallelly, I'm trying to do all this work of meeting ends meet with my internet business. I actually literally would go places and do an internet problem and answer to leke aajaunga. I swear. You know what happened in my life? I will never go back home because I'm an equal rebellion. My cash flows have been directed. End of the day, I have to meet salaries for disclosure also, even though I have outstanding. So I have taken enough loan from Eddie Fenton family. It means I'm living a life on really whosoever can pay me for that day. So I was selling domain names, search engine marketing, web hosting, training consulting, and running all the money from this side to the mobile business that I wanted to do. And I reached lows of my life. Just want to share one low in my life. I had days and I did not have money for dinner. And it was 10:30 p.m. I didn't know whom to ask for it. I used to figure out I had 15 rupees. The decision was 10 rupee coke and 5 rupee bourbon on this. That was my dinner. I had days when I had not enough money and I literally will walk through the places because I would not do those blue line passes. As in, you know, not paying the bus. So I would decide I have 6 rupees, which will mean this stop to that stop will be the bus. I would do foot walk. I would have dinners which are coke driven. That is why my this. In college days, I used to be 46 kgs. I'm not so much high either now. But my parents were brewing something even superior for me. Beke, tumhari shaadi nahi hogi agar tum aise kaam karte raho. We are tagged. After everything is done, I've done my job. No more questions, no more conversations. I couldn't go to Stanford and you're telling me this is like this. And what? You know, I was 25 years actually. My father, again, you know, I don't want to say negative about those things, except just that this is really the social structure that we live in, guys. So many of you might be going through and not sharing this fact. I went through this moment when my father said it. If you don't have a job of 30,000 rupees a month and cannot make your ends meet, I got to know that your landlord made a phone call that you not pay so many months rent. What will happen to that sort of conversation? And I was like, okay, I'll do it. Thank you for calling me, you know. But I had now very clear dictate for my parents. You know, just, you know, shut it all off and then take a job. Take a job so that you can get married. That's the reason. Another reason for a family which is like a Brahmin family out of that side of the world where they used to think that this guy doesn't get a job, that's why he's doing this job. That's why he's doing this. You know what I mean? They thought that I'm not worth getting employed, that's why I'm trying to do these things. People in the community were saying that. The signed domains company I was talking about, I turned them around. They started making $20,000 a month. Quickly. This guy says, why don't you become CEO for our company? I said, I have a company myself. This is what company does. He said, what does this company do? I gave him a big speech about how mobile is going to change the world. The equal speech I gave for the time when I had a job. And I said that, you know, this is what will be the thing. It will be bigger than internet. And he says, really? You were doing internet so nicely. So what happens to that? So I said, I really cannot give up to that. So he decided a deal with me that to hire, we'll give you 50% of time for your company and 50% time here. I'll pay you 30,000 rupees salary and you'll be called CEO of Stein Domains. And I was like, oh my god, my father's thing is done. Even though my father's thing was being done, the only thing that I really was scared about was otherwise, how could you get a job if you were like a start the entrepreneur for 4 years, you no more do programming, I anyway never did programming, and then you are not no more of MBA which any marketing company will hire you or a role. You know what, BPO was fashionable, I thought I'll get an admin job. I swear on God, I thought I'll get an admin job, this is better, at least my internet mein toh kaam kar lunga kuch. Oh, this guy swings the fortune of my life My family thinks I'm CEO. This guy doesn't pay me money here. I'm living stretch life in two worlds, internet and mobile. This is in GK1, Sirifort Road. This is in Karol Bagh. So I'm running between these two places. The petrol bills are mine. I have more overhead and less money. You know what I'm showing? So I tell him, please give me some money. Okay, so how much money do you need? He did not understand that I was asking salary. He thought how much money you need for the company. And I thought this could be the moment that 8 lakh rupees can be get paid. I said 8 lakh rupees. 8 lakh rupees. Okay, very good. So what is your company's balance sheet and whatever stuff? I figured out. I did not even know how much money I made. By the way, I in that year made 84 lakh. So this guy says, okay, we'll do two things together. I'll give you 8 lakh rupees and I'll also put you together in same company, which is like same physical office place, because your people will use that space, so I'll give you the furniture cost. So total payout towards you 16 lakh rupees, 40% equity. That's my angel. That's my angel round after 4 years of my company struggle. 8 lakh rupees the loan cleared, via company getting the loan, money actually not loan, and 8 lakh rupees worth of furniture, so that I can live these companies together. I split later on, by the way, that I don't want this company to be managed, I'll remain here. That is why I remain. Fast forward. Now that I have this money, these big blue, those who are challenging the mobile content industry, actually, I had figured out that it is irrelevant to get into content business. It is better to get into marketing business, because 10,000 people will make content. It will be more important to get content discovered, content marketed. So I quickly moved towards the marketing side. So from entertainment, I moved to the marketing side. I started doing go-to-market for these ring-back tones that started coming in. I started doing customer analytics, prepaid analytics. Operator used to give me all customer data, still does. All of your phone numbers, records, if you are not on BSNL, are in my office. They are. I kind of know who calls you, where do you live in the night. Those kind of things. I can decipher. That is how operators bully. In logon ko ringback tone ke ye char gaane sunayenge. To ye ek khareed lenge. Kyunki wo char gaane choose karna itna massive analytics hai. I won't tell you. I manage like a massive Hadoop cluster in the office. Terabytes of data comes in my place, and 450 million unique users of this country's months and years of data. Then I run these marketing platforms, so then on top of it, I have your experience behavior. When I showed you this, what did you do? So that's like my core business now, marketing, mobile marketing. Now that I could market everything, I said I'll take the revenge of the entertainment industry and the content industry, right? I decided to create a business called selling contents, because now I know what consumers want. I decided I will not get no royalty content that was created in the house, and we could sell it to the consumers. So if you remember a couple of days back when the Jaiho ringtone was being sold, ringback tone, there was a ringback tone. Why do you call me? I don't have to do it. My office lady has recorded it. We knew how to sell it well. We knew how to get it sold. So we today change fortunes of content industry that every month hundreds of millions of songs get downloaded. I literally mean hundreds of millions. And then every month we move around. Okay, so my marketing business is about $30 million that I get net. That's a summary. I built this content thing back. I started doing subscription content, which is created for consumers in their custom method. I went back. 2007 is the time when I started trying to raise my first round of funding. First round of funding was even funny moment. A college senior who knew me, worked in PwC, said, why don't we raise funds for you? I said, sounds good, because otherwise I will not know what else I can do, because I have a limitation of platforms that I want to put. You know those voice platforms that I was talking about? This was pulled behind my rug, below my rug. I started putting these platforms by virtue of the loan that gentleman gave me, the money that gentleman gave me. I needed more money. When I met or attempted to meet VCs, named people said that everybody who's worth funding has been funded. By the way, this on mobile company had raised $57 million by that time. I was going to do my first $1 million fundraise. Okay? This is 2007. Companies which were otherwise, you know, in the industry, they raised tens and twenties of millions of dollars. So one of the best guys whom I thought they'll raise money, they are investors in Yahoo, Google. No, it's not Sequoia. Clue, it's not Sequoia. Google side. So they said, I told you, right? Everybody who's worth funding has got funded. So I was given these elevator pitch movements. Literally, like, I have this Thai conference at 8:30. I'll finish my breakfast by 8. I have some time between 8 and 8:30. Should you have an opportunity, meet me. A guy who's like engineer, who doesn't have money, cash flow problems, you get an opportunity to make these pitches in 15-20 minutes. I made that pitch. Don't know what output was. Another meeting I went. This young man, a young man called Sanjeev Agarwal. I was like passionate about how mobile is going to be and how it is changing one industry called entertainment, how will it change industry called marketing, and how in future will it change industry called commerce, and how I am at the pinnacle of it. I need money to build this massive platform because it will all be in the cloud. And I need a lot of money so that I can put it. My pitch was enough passionate, and he actually patted on my back and said that, Vijay, this country needs few of you who build $5 million of companies based on their 5 lakh rupees. I was in tears. I said, sir, you do not know. Since my school days, nobody has ever patted on my back. Actually, that was like 15 years later, I got second pat on my back. This is enough, even if you don't give me money, to let me continue. I met a few more. I was raising fund in the month of November. Some people raise money in the month of November because December VCs go on holidays of their annual days. Some saw something in me, enough to say that I started getting term sheets from Sequoia, Kleiner, obviously Sharpalo comes back, Delian, Matrix, and a guy called Staff Partners. He was my college senior actually. So he like parked himself in my office for 2 days. And I was like, oh God, this will come again. And then he said that, he kept asking me, how do I come, what is in me, and so on and so forth. I had a very clear statement. I have to kill this company out of Bangalore. There's no reason. They stole my idea. Voila. And I will not, I don't have billions of dollars in my back, and I will not fight till the death, but I said that I know that they are not original, so they are riding the thing that I did, but they can't ride the thing that I will do, as I need money for that sort of conversation. So he was like, oh, Crusader, here you get the money of this Gallantry Award winner money. I signed a term sheet on 19th of December. First round funding came. I got money by the March end, actually. This takes so much of time for those who do not know. When I got money, 2007 or March, in September I spent all this money because I wanted to put more and more of these servers which were like platform which could do anything on top of it. I started building more servers. I started raising second round of fund. This same company gave me more money. So in that year I spent tens of millions, which is literally 50 of crore rupees, on building this platform. I was doing marketing, they were not bothered about, I was selling their content. So I found out something to get my platform across nook and corner of the country so that I can do more things on the top of it. Soon, I decided to raise more round because I needed more money, and I thought that now there is an Infosys baby, there will be some other tech company baby. So it was like a orphan sort of feeling in my mind, literally I mean it. So I was romancing with every private equity player, Carlyle, Sanshi, HSBC, you can imagine everybody. Borrowed Pincus was my dream because Bharti was built on Borrowed Pincus' funding. Borrowed Pincus from New York says that we cut 40 million checks, not less. For you it's 25 million should you want to raise it. Except that I did not want to give so much of equity or had no clue how can I use 25 million. I had number of people, I started saying I will not need money, don't give me the term sheet right now. I was in that high tide. Soon the market will collapse. It's 2008, October, November, and the market is tanking, and I'm living in my high tide of the people are calling me, take money. My banker said, Vijay, let's not trade high, let's take a term sheet now. I decided to take non-exclusive term sheets from HSBC and Intel Capital because I thought these are two good names. I picked up finally Intel. The world was down, I was being chased. I'm like, surprise, reverse trends. Took the money from Intel, build this platform even to that maximum. And I can tell you that today, the platform that we have is like hundreds of thousands of ports. And I can tell you, it is reaching a million concurrent ports in this country. I handle billions of calls in a day. And that size of the traffic that I handle. Actually, it can't be on a million port, billion calls. So I just want to tell you that it takes 2 or 3 days still. But that said, billions of calls come in a week. My platform, every day, interacts by the end of 30 days or a month. 400 unique users a month. This is by far the bigger reach than any goddamn platform in this country can be. It reaches 400 people use this platform. We make more money in mobile marketing than anybody can speak in this country. We make it with profit. We do the content. And this year, we started getting into commerce. Let's see where we go in 3 years. Seen the speech to be done, who's been done, third we'll see in 3 years. That's about it. Thank you.